Thank you.
Hello there.
It's present for a good citizen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. Ellemann-Jensen.
Thank you.
Hello there.
Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you.
Louise Bell.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. President.
Hello.
Thank you.
Mr. President. John Scarf.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. How you doing?
Thank you.
Hello there.
Thank you. Thank you. One little change. The end of a roll. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Boy, wait till I tell my wife we're all playing hooky.
Nothing.
He's going to be here.
Yes, sir.
President,
See you. Shouldn't we get a group picture here?
Fine. I'd like to, or take a picture, is give you a copy of our book, Jews, American Wars, because we have an understanding history.
Well, I know that, and I'm very pleased and proud to have this. Thank you very much.
And another token I'd like to present to you, Mr. President. It's just a symbol or token of our appreciation for having us and giving us the opportunity of speaking with you.
Well, thank you. Very much. I'm well aware of the service your organization has done to the people who defended our way of life, and I'm most appreciative, honored to have you here.
Well, I've given Max here a copy of a brochure we have on a member of our faith who served our country very valiantly during the Korean War, and we're going to see if we can get him proper recognition for the service he gave our country that he had served in the Korea. Was a prisoner of war, had been an inmate in a concentration camp as a child, and served our country before he even became a citizen. But we're going to look into that, that further.
Well, I can't match anything of this. You've been more generous than I could. At least I just thought I'm going to give you a souvenir of your visit here, a keychain, the seal.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. I really appreciate that. And I want you to know that Colonel Bernstein and I had the opportunity of being in Berlin this past Veterans Day.
Oh.
And your comments in regard to the wall at the Brandenburg Gate is something that I certainly appreciated, because I wholeheartedly agree with you, sir, that you can't appreciate it until you see it firsthand. Pictures don't tell the story.
I have to tell you, I enjoyed myself saying it very much.
Well, we saw it from the other side also, and it was a little eerie to see these Germans goose-stepping. Was certainly a memory that we will never forget. And the courtesies extended to us by the Department of Defense and everything was very much appreciated.
Mr. President, Colonel Bernstein was recently retired as the Assistant Superintendent at West Point.
Yes,
sir. The military academy.
Well, I'm very proud to have both of you here. And I look forward to the book and the brochure.
Okay, fine. Thank you very much, sir. Really appreciate it.
Pleasure. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. President, thank you for all the good work on our campus. Oh, and Nancy, too. Really super. Keep doing it.
We will.
Thank you, sir.
You're a super.
Yes, this seems to be a different feeling to
me. New atmosphere.
Thank you, sir.
Hello there, Mr. Francis. Well, great pleasure to see you.
Thank you, sir. Sir, right here. Thank you.
All right.
And ma'am, the ambassador.
Yes.
And of course, Aaron.
Mr. President, how are you? Very nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Well, looking forward to working together here with your country now in charge of the European community, and you handling the foreign relations part of that. And incidentally, we're very grateful for the course that you followed with regard to the oils and fats and the trade restrictions on them. It would have been quite a problem for us, and I think it would have added to our battle against protectionism up on the Hill if that had succeeded. We're most grateful.
Thank you, Mr. President. We are certainly appreciative of the way in which you are fighting protectionism yourself. And what we did to the oils and fats, even though it left us with some problems, was certainly in order to support your life.
We're most appreciative.
Mr. President, may I bring you the warmest greetings from my queen, who has dear recollection when she met you, the First Lady, in 72, I think.
Yes.
It was at Rayfield.
Yes, and please, our warm regards and many happy memories of our time there. The President then, I was still the governor, and the president had asked me to represent him at the Raybuild 4th of July celebration. And it was a wonderful and heartwarming experience.
I can tell you, this year, Mr. President, it was the biggest turnout for many years. Almost 30,000 people showed up at Raybuild.
Well,
and it was the only summer day we had in Denmark so far this year. So what more can we do to warm up America?
And you missed it very well. Your message was very well received. I read it.
Well, that's quite a unique ceremony there on 4th of July. Yes. There, in a society that's dedicated to the Americans of Danish background.
Your daughter was there last year, Mr. President. I think she liked it. I went with her to this place in Aalborg, where you get a member of the guild, the old Christians, the Forest Guild. And your daughter gave a speech, a greeting from you last year. Big success.
I told her she was going to enjoy it.
She did. Thank you, sir. She did.
Mr. President, I hope, as you said, that during the 6 months in which we have the presidency of the community, that we can strengthen the links across the Atlantic. We certainly want to take away whatever tensions there may be and to support you not only with regard to trade problems you're facing, but also with your stand in the INF negotiations. We are very happy with the stance the United States government is taking.
Thank you. We'll stay with it.
Okay. Well, very good. Mr. President, thank you for giving me your time.
Listen, thank you for coming.
Thank you, sir.
As I say, my return my warmest regards to Her Majesty.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President. When I was there, yes. I have to tell you what the young people I have to tell about. They were still talking about the war and the German occupation. That's one day the king tried to get to see his horse.
Yes.
And the German soldiers there in the street said, who is that? And they said, that is our king. Well, they said, oh, it can't be. Where is his security? Where is his protection?
Yes.
And they said, we're his protection.
Mr. President, that's not even a story. That's the plain truth.
Yes. That's the way I was talking.
Exactly.
Unfortunately, in the end of the war, his horse got hit because he did that every morning. In the end of the war, some bomb went off. His horse got scared. He got thrown off and got badly injured and wasn't invalid for the rest of his life.
Oh,
but he did until then, every morning, show himself to the people of Copenhagen. Mm-hmm. Great man.
Yes. Yes. Well.
Thank you,
Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. President, have you know Colonel Dick Beasley?
I sure do.
Wife?
Mr. President?
You can see him from behind.
Yes, sir. His wife, Susan?
Hello.
His daughter, Melissa?
And his son, Matthew?
I think if you get in the middle here, you ladies, it would be a prettier picture. We have a family picture. The young man there join us.
That's great. Very good smiles. Thanks.
Well, sorry to see you go, but can understand why? You know, you won't be losing all those weekends.
Yes, I'll be glad to have you home.
Well, I can't tell you how much I've appreciated the opportunity, Mr. President. Like my troops say, we fly many DOD, head of states, vice presidents, but you're the friendliest man they ever meet. That goes.
Sakes, thank you very much.
Well, they're thanking you through me, but they work very hard on the helicopters, and they say all the time, the President, no matter how busy he is, always has time to say thank you and good afternoon or acknowledge their presence. You'd be amazed at the number of VIPs who are pseudo-VIPs compared to you who walk by them and don't even acknowledge their presence. So from us to you, thank you for making our job so enjoyable.
I'll wait just 1 second. I should go without a few souvenirs. Oh dear. I broke this loose so it is going to look as pretty as it is, but I just tore it out of its fastening.
That's okay.
That's for you. It's a bookmark.
Oh, thank you so much.
And a charm.
Thank you.
And a key ring.
Thank you.
And a little souvenir of the Oval Office for you.
Mr. President, thank you very much.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
See you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.